Today we're making espresso rum brownies. The process is as follows. You first begin with putting butter and with a blender cream it as much as possible. Look at how beautiful it looks as a creamy mixture. Keep cleaning the sides of the vessel and moving it to the center and creaming it again. And continue this process until you find the butter as creamy as it can be and as creamy as you like it. Then add powdered sugar to the vessel and beat it so that it mixes well with the butter and you see no lumps. Then add the espresso which you may have already set aside by mixing coffee powder into hot water. We have used Old Monk rum. We're taking half a cup of rum and adding it to our butter sugar mixture. Now you'll realize that when you start beating, mixture will take a lot of time to blend because remember, water doesn't mix well with butter. And hence, while you keep blending and blending and blending, after quite an amount of time, you will get a good mixture. Just look at how it looks now. This has been at least 5 to 7 minutes of continuous blending on high speed. Break one egg at a time and mix it. What we've done is just broken 2 eggs and blended it with the in the same vessel. Now again you'll see that it starts to disintegrate because the egg is liquidy. Then add in some dark chocolate. Make sure it is cooled down before you mix it. Start blending and you'll see the color changing to a lightish brown. Again, clear the sides of the vessel and keep moving the mixture to the center and then mixing the batter again. When the entire batter is well blended, please add your baking powder. Put 1.5 cup of all-purpose flour or maida and sieve it into the mixture and start blending slowly. Initially, it will fly within the vessel. Make sure you start on a low speed and then move towards high. Pour the mixture into a lined baking tray. At the side, please preheat your oven at 190 degrees. Once it's preheated, keep the tray into the oven for 30 minutes. Once the timing is up, remove the baking tray carefully. Check whether it is baked with a toothpick. We haven't done it here in the video, but we definitely checked. And then flip it onto a plate or a tray and allow it to set for 2 hours. We're just pressing it to see how fluffy it is because we were excited. Cut it into the blocks as per the size that you would like to have it. So we cut it vertically, horizontally. So we cut really tiny pieces because we were sharing it with a lot of people. And now look at the final product.